promising for campgrounds girls. Griff, you're okay? How are you?
How are you?
Good.
You got a pass?
I do have a pass.
Perfect, thank you.
Do you want me to read it to you?
Yep, you're good. Yep, okay. Thank you so much.
So, are any of the campgrounds open?
No.
No. Yeah, so we can't.
All
closed for the season. Oh, I see. So we can't spend the night in the park anywhere.
Yeah. The only thing is that you do not country camping.
I sleep in my car.
Unfortunately.
No.
Yeah, you're not allowed to do that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can give me a nap.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome.
So I think we'll probably come back tomorrow then. Find a place to stay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, so there's no camping in the park. They're closed for the season. Okay, no problem. Plan B or C or whatever. Shenandoah National Park in Virginia, getting ready to run the Overall Falls Trail, which is technically a hike, but I was looking at the elevation profile and I think I can run it, or at least most of it. And supposedly there are black bears around here. Yes, this is it. This is the trail.
build. Oh, baby, they're tumbling down. And they didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make a sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had a doubt. Standing in the light of your halo, I got my angel now. It's like I've been awakened.
To be a 6.5 mile trail loop, and I've already run 9 miles, and I have no idea where the start is, where my car is, or where I am. There's no hope. Yeah, so not only are my shoes no longer dry, but neither are my pants. Thanks to this mofo. I'm freezing. It's moments like this when living out of my car sucks. Girls, how are the babies? Hi. It's the day after the Shenandoah National Park experience. I ended up getting terribly lost at the park. I was supposed to do a 6.5 mile loop run, and somehow I got completely disoriented, completely turned around. Everything started looking the same. 11.5 miles later, I was finally at a spot where I could get a signal on my phone. and I called the police to come to my rescue. I reported myself lost. I thought I was really close to the car where the G girls were, which was stressing me out even more. But when I looked at my map data, I was headed the complete opposite direction. I was nowhere near my car. So the police came, they brought a heated blanket and coffee, super nice. The officer did tell me that this happens very frequently, unfortunately. They have to rescue people sometimes 5-10 rescues per week. And the signs are, there's definitely room for improvement left as far as signage and maps are concerned, but and no excuse, it's my responsibility to know the trail and know where I'm going. And so it was a difficult day toward the end. I didn't film any of it because I didn't want to be disrespectful to the officer, plus I wasn't really in the mood. Lessons learned, and gorgeous park. Really glad I got to experience it. I wish it had a better ending, but it's good. It's good to be rattled. I've said many, many times I don't like easy things. It's just that it makes me upset, the fact that this was a difficult experience, and that's because it was my fault. So, it's okay. Lesson learned. Our next stop is in South Carolina via North Carolina. We are close to the border with North Carolina, my old stomping ground, and I'm looking forward to our next experience. Ta-ta for now.